Hi, my name is Sharka and I want to show you a new version of EBSYNTH that we're launching today. EBSYNTH is a video editing software that lets you transform a video by making changes to a still frame. What does that mean? Well, let's say that you have a video from your vacation in Paris where you're eating a French baguette, but it looks too plain and you want your mom to see that you're eating your vegetables, so you'd like to turn the baguette into a nice tomato sandwich. If it was a photo, you could do the edit in Photoshop. But how do you manipulate a video like that? And that's where EBSYNTH steps in. You play a video in it, and when you pause it, you can edit that frozen frame just like a photo. And when you hit play, EBSYNTH propagates your changes to the rest of the video. So you're editing still frames, and EBSYNTH is applying those edits to entire videos. Now what can you actually do with that? Well, you can take a video of a duck and turn it into a dragon. Or become a living portrait in Hogwarts. You can create fictional worlds, it's up to you. Just experiment and explore ideas. You can make pretty cool stuff with very basic setups. But you don't always have to make big transformations. EBSYNTH gives you enough control to do subtle video touch-ups as well, like digital makeup. And the video doesn't have to be live action. You can add more details to your animation too. Or use your own performance to bring your characters to life. You can even rotoscope short films with EBSYNTH, like Joel Haver did. Basically, any edit you can make to a photo, you can now make to a video. So EBSYNTH is like Photoshop for videos. And I want to show you how to use it now, so let's open it and let's do something in it. EBSYNTH runs in the browser, so you don't have to install anything. Just go to ebsynth.com and click on Get Started. And this is it. That's EBSYNTH. And I need a video, so I'm going to pick one from the library. For example, this lynx. Okay, and now I'm going to pause it and find a frame where I can see his face, like this one. And I'm going to take a brush and draw him a cool pair of glasses. Like that. Okay, so this is my edit, and when I hit play, it propagates to the rest of the video. Yeah, so there we go, a video of our lynx wearing glasses. But that happened pretty fast, so I'm going to pause it and explain what's going on. Let's start with the timeline. You might notice this green diamond over here, and that's a keyframe, and it represents my edit, in this case my drawing of the glasses. In EBSYNTH, you always make your edits for a specific video frame so they match and they are paired up, and you can see that in the left panel. Here you have a list of all your keyframes next to their matching video frames. And on the right, you have layers. Every keyframe consists of layers, so you can work non-destructively. In fact, I'm going to create a new layer here and add some lenses to the glasses. So now we have sunglasses. Let's see if it works. Okay, that's starting to look good, but do you see how the glasses kind of break here? That happens when the video changes too much from what it looks like in the keyframe, and the lynx turned his head to the side, but my keyframe was frontal, and so EBSYNTH doesn't know what the glasses should look like from the side. So I need to make a new keyframe here and fix this. You make a new keyframe by clicking on this diamond, and if you look into the left panel, you can see that the keyframe is added to the list, and the propagated frame is loaded as the first layer, which is really useful because now I can just fill this gap with one brushstroke like that, and it's fixed. And as you can see, EBSYNTH seamlessly blends between the two keyframes. So yeah, the sunglasses are done. Let's add something else to the lynx wardrobe. I think that a necklace would look good on him, so I'm going to create a new track for that. And I'm not going to paint it. I want to use a photo, and I've prepared this one, so I'm going to drop it in and fit the necklace to his neck. And now I need to erase the overflowing bits, like that. And it's ready to go, so let's see. Okay, that works. So the gangster links is done, and you've seen how the interface works and how to make some basic keyframes, but there is more, so let's move on. I'll make a new project for that and pick another video. There. And now I want to make a pen sketch of this guy, and I'm gonna make the edit in Photoshop, because you don't have to create your keyframes in EBSYNTH. You can prepare them in any software you want, and I want to show you how that works. So, I'm in Photoshop, and now what? I kinda need something to edit, right? I need the video frame as a reference. So, I'll go back to EBSYNTH, and make an empty keyframe, and now I can save the video frame by going to the left panel and clicking on this button here. And this saves the image to my computer, so I can open it in Photoshop and make my edit here. And I'm going to cheat and play an action for the pen sketch because I need the result quickly, but you can do whatever you want. And there it is. So this is my new keyframe. I'm going to save it as a PNG and then go back to EBSYNTH and load it into the keyframe slot by clicking on this folder button, like that. So our keyframe's in, let's play it. Yeah, that works pretty nicely. So we have an animated pen sketch and it doesn't even need more keyframes, which is nice. I'm gonna do a quick recap. Here you're saving your image references and here you are loading finished keyframes. So it's easy as that. And now I want to show you another way to create keyframes in EBSYNTH. So let me open a new video for that. Okay, and now I have this beautiful sleepy lion here, and if I pause it and click on those little stars, I get a prompt window where I can generate my keyframes. And the cool thing about this is that any image you generate here will keep the structure of the video frame, which is essential for EBSYNTH. So let's try it out. I want to generate a keyframe that looks like a painting, so I'm going to put that in the prompt. Beautiful painting of a sleepy lion, expressive brushstrokes, artwork. There, generate. Ooh, that's pretty good. I mean, you can keep generating until you like the result, but I'm good with this. And I want to see how EBSYNTH deals with it, so let's play it. Yeah, the face is going to need a bit more attention, but the rest looks fine. Yeah, the lion changed poses, see, and that's difficult for EBSYNTH. So this was the keyframe pose, and this is the new pose, and EBSYNTH couldn't quite render it. So I'm gonna make a new keyframe here and fix this area. So I'm going to select it. Now open the prompt window and lower the strength. Now this is still going to generate a new face for the lion, but it will keep his identity. With lower strength, you're basically running a polishing pass over the frame you already have, which is exactly what I need now. So I set the strength to 30% and I'm gonna hit generate. And there we go. So the lion's face is fixed. Let's see how the video looks. Okay, so far so good. And the transition looks smooth too, so I'm happy with that. And I know that it's not perfect, and I have a few more tricks to improve that, but I'll make a detailed tutorial next time. This is just the basics, and I have one more basic trick for you. I want the lion to turn into the painting a little later in the video, so I'm going to grab the edge of the track and move it like that. And I also want a smoother transition. I want a fade in. And to do that, I'll just click on this little arrow, which will open an opacity curve. And now I can use these little beads to create my fade in, like that. Okay, so let's have a look at the final result. Okay, good. And to finish up, I want to save the video, so I'm going to click on export. And one more time, wait a little bit for it to render, and hit save. And that's it. That's the end of my tutorial. I hope that you found it useful. And before you go, I just want to say a huge thank you to all the EBSYNTH creators, because seeing your work has definitely motivated us to finish this update. And by us, I mean Andre and me, because we made EBSYNTH together and we want to keep improving it. So if there's anything that could make it better for you, please reach out and tell us. You can join our Discord or send us an email, and we will be happy for any feedback. All right, so that's it from me. Thank you so much for watching and have a great day. Bye.